You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Keith Walker's nasty tale of political chicanery. The tiger cages. Starring Shelley. In the Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company and Lazy Boy Recliners. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
Day-to-day problems of another country to his readers. When this job is complicated by official censorship and obstruction, the job becomes dangerous and difficult. You're about to meet Sam Albertson, an investigative reporter of the first rank. Sam's problem is to unravel the lies and half-truths of the official handouts of governments in order to uncover the existence of a concentration camp for political prisoners.
No, Archie, I don't want to leave this wonderful bar.
Come on, Sam, let's go home.
Well, you agree, don't you? Old David Halberstam, finest reporter this crummy country ever saw.
Sure, I agree. Now, let's go.
You like my story on the black market? Government deny no black market. Poof, no black market, just black magic.
Sam, the world's in ears.
A nose and not two eyes. Whee! You right, you are, sergeant. That's your bald McIntyre.
All right, come on. Your arm around my shoulder.
Yep. Gotta file my copy before the embassy issues their rebuttal. It wouldn't look nice for them to do their rebuttal before I can do my copy.
Come on in the Jeep, old friend.
Mr. Albertson.
Who's that? Come out into the light so as I can see.
What do you want, lady?
Is this American correspondent Albertson?
Sure. Who's a lovely thing like you out this late?
I must talk with you. Please, we go somewhere private.
Don't! Both of you! Behind the jeep!
What is it?
Everybody okay?
Yes.
What was that all about?
I am afraid it was for me, Mr. Albertson. Only I did not think it was so close. I am sorry to put you and the sergeant in danger. I will go.
Whoa, right there, lassie. With that initiation to the club, I think you owe us an explanation.
All right. May we go somewhere and talk?
Sure, but who are you?
My name is Lee Van Nguyen.
Would that be old Trot Van Nguyen's daughter?
Yes.
Well.
We are safe here, Mr. Albertson?
Sure. Belongs to a friend of wire service. He's in Japan for a week.
Here, drinks. Lee, I've always admired your father. He's one of the main hopes for this country.
Thank you, but I think it is no more.
Why?
My father is missing. I think kidnapped by the palace secret police.
Nah, it can't be. I just spoke with him 2 nights ago at a reception.
That is why I came to you. My father and many countrymen have great respect for your stories. Also, you are not afraid to speak out when my country or yours is wrong.
Well, you'd better fill me in quick. I'm afraid I'm not long for this country.
I understand. I read your stories on the pacification program. Does not your country get upset?
Oh, just a few of them, honey. Why do you think he's been kidnapped?
He has spoken out for a coalition government.
Coalition government?
It means it includes communist Archie Lee. Are you sure it was the palace? Couldn't it have been the Liberation Front?
No. They do not like my father, but it is their policy to let him alone. They feel that although he is not a friend, neither is he an enemy.
So the great democracy strikes again. When did it happen?
Last night. A squad broke into our house. Then they took my father.
Have you been to the palace?
No. I was afraid for my own life. If I had been home, I think they would have also taken me. But there is one man. From Doc Tao.
Sounds like an American game,
Archie.
Oh, sorry?
He is a minor clerk at the palace and an old family friend. He sent a note telling me he had information of my father.
Have you seen him yet?
No. He asked that you be with me.
Can you reach him now?
I will try. There is a phone?
Oh, yes, in the bedroom.
If she gets him, you want to go along, Archie?
I wouldn't have missed it for the world.
What is this place, Lee?
It is the old pagoda where the Buddhists made their stand. I do not understand why Fong is not here. The person who took the message said he would come.
Sam, Lee, there's someone behind the columns. You stay put.
I am afraid, Sam.
Shh. Let the old Scottish Indian look around.
Sam, quick. Knock here.
Mr. Tao,
can you hear us? What happened?
Mr. Albertson?
Son, we should get him to a hospital. He's been tortured pretty bad.
Oh, no, Yan. Hurt your father, great man. Roxanne.
No, please don't die, Mr. Please.
Sam, Lee, anybody hurt?
I'm getting very tired of being shot at.
Why would they try to kill us, Sam?
They're not trying to kill us, Lee. They're just trying to frighten me off.
Hello, beautiful and sexy.
Oh, Sam Albertson, you'll scare me to death sneaking up on me like that.
Where's our eye?
In his office, but he won't see you.
How'd you like the best dinner this town has to offer?
The best dinner this city can offer is the one Pan Am serves on their nightly flight home.
Ah, the city of pleasure is getting to you.
No, but I wish you would.
Hey, Louise, call upstairs and have him hold the diplomatic pouch for an insert. Hello, Albertson.
Just the man I want to see.
Nothing doing. You get the handout at 5 as usual.
Denton, I'm doing a story on Roxanne.
Come in. Now, you forget Roxanne.
Oh, that's the sore spot, huh?
Listen, I don't give a darn about your readership. We're fighting a war out here, and I'm sick of your muckraking.
Well, I can't think of a better place to do it.
Listen, Sam, we've got to get along with the palace. You know that. So maybe there's a few things we don't like.
Like the war? Listen, there's a nice little man who got himself all sliced apart last night, so I want some answers. The last thing he said was Roxanne.
I don't know a thing.
It took too long.
You know, you're skating on thin ice with the ambassador.
Sure, but I skate a mean line.
Any more stories like the one on the troops in the Delta, you'll find yourself on the way home.
I've been discredited by better governments, but I'll tell you this. Everything's been done by this administration to cover for the inept and corrupt government of this country. And it's my job to point it out. You want to throw me out, do it. Till then, don't get in the way of the truth. Now, what is Roxanne?
Forget it, Sam. You'll get us all in trouble. Now, wait. Look, sometimes I don't like it any more than you do, Sam.
Roxanne.
All right, talk to Aaron Rosen.
Yeah, okay, but I thought he was spooking it in Cambodia.
That's it, Sam.
Thanks.
McIntyre.
Albertson, what's the password?
Seven.
You got it. And Archie, bring your spook captain along.
Well, how'd you know he was back?
There's a banner at the airport. Tell him I have a friend I want him to meet.
Oh, you mean the Borny lass? You love it?
Check 7 at Doc Kuyen's.
Sam, over here.
Where's Lee?
I thought she'd come with you.
No, she said she'd meet us here. Funny, it's already after 7.
She'll get here. Oh, Sam.
Aaron Rosen. Captain, thanks for coming.
Try Aaron. What are you drinking, Sam?
Gin that kills anything that lands in it.
Right. Look, Ginny Tom.
Sam,
I told Aaron about the other night.
Now, what do you make of it?
I think you're climbing on a limb that'll drop you. Archie says you want to know about Roxanne.
Yep.
You'll have to wipe me as your source.
Understood.
There's a rumor going around among the spooks that the current regime has built themselves a miniature devil's island for political prisoners. Roxanne's an island about 140 miles south, about 60 off the coast.
Far enough away so you can't hear their screams.
That's the scam.
kind of world coming?
Doc gets crazier all the time,
but we love him.
Do you think this Trock Van Noyen is out there?
That's the only thing I can figure. They kidnap him, torture him, and get some sort of confession he's working for the enemy. Makes it easier for them to execute him.
Is that kind of evidence admissible?
In their courts it is. Excuse me, I'm going to give the girl a call. Be right back.
Aaron, when do you go back into camp?
I'm due for a couple of days' rest. But the brass think they've spotted a small bamboo prison camp where the enemy is keeping some of our guys. If they get confirmation, we'll try and bring them out.
There. That means us. Good. I'm getting tired of headquarters.
Archie, Aaron, we got troubles. I called Lee. Someone answered the phone, then nothing but silence. Then I thought I heard a scream.
How far's the house?
5 minutes.
Okay, let's go.
Lights upstairs. Give me a boost up.
Archie, I'll roll back. Try and get in. Sam, stand on my shoulders.
Okay. I got hold of the veranda. Aaron, two men inside. They've got Lee stripped and tied to a chair.
Sam, catch.
A gun. What am I going to do with this?
Use it if you have to. I'm going around front. Create a diversion. It should bring one of them downstairs.
Hang on, Lee. Freeze. Easy, Lee. Sammy will get you untied.
Sam, you okay?
Yeah, help me untie Lee.
Sam, thank you. They do terrible things to me.
Yeah, here, put this on. What do they want?
Easy, Sergeant. It's me.
They torture me, Sam. They want to know how much I tell you. Who is Captain?
A friend, Captain Aaron Rosen.
Captain, I heard a grenade.
Yeah, mine. I got one guy. Looks like Sam here completed the job.
Lee, did they say anything about your father?
They were special police. They say he at Roxon. Very bad place. They torture me to find out how much I tell you. Oh, Sam, I think they will kill my father.
Aaron, how could we get her father out?
It wouldn't be easy.
I didn't ask that.
I know. Maybe a small raiding party in a chopper.
Aaron, they'll break us all the way back to our recruits.
Us? You thinking of going along?
Always on your team, Captain.
And I'm in. I want to see what they're doing at Roxanne.
I am going too.
You can't.
No, you must understand. It might be possible to bribe my father out.
Yeah. I forgot about the way things are done here.
Aaron, how'd you manage this jolly green giant?
That, my son, is a spook secret. Suffice to say that this is a rescue helicopter and this is a rescue, right?
Captain Aaron, why you do this?
Because, lovely lady, your father has said some fine things that make a lot of sense to this gnarled believer of freedom.
Bravo. The best speech I've heard you make.
Aaron, how are you going to get us down out of the island?
Simple. You just watch. I figure we're about there. You got the money, Miss Lee?
Yes.
Smart, Aaron.
Nothing to it. We're down. Here comes a guard. Remember, stay out of sight until we've gone to parlay, then take a look around. Archie, I'll take the pilot with me. You stay with the civilian.
Come on! Don't get past! You arrest! Come on!
All right, we heard you. Take us to your commander.
You come out! Don't get back!
Let's go, Shorty. See your captain.
Don't get back! Come on! Don't get back!
All clear. Come on.
That is terrible.
I know. Sounds like hundreds of people.
Sam, Lee, over this way. Looks like they got the place lit up like Coney Island. Here, climb up this hill.
Oh, Sam, look.
Oh, no, I've believed it. It's like something out of Dante.
Yeah. Looks like buried tiger cages.
I feel so helpless.
Hang in there.
That is what's called penal reform.
Down there, look. They've got 10 people jammed into those cages. Can't be more than 5 by 9 feet.
The government is pig.
You are under arrest!
Good, they found you.
What's going on?
Like the lady said, bribery. They got a sweet system here. $2 or $3 for a nobody. For Trock, the whole grand. Lee, give me the money.
You got to somebody.
Yeah. Trock's being brought by an obliging captain of the guard.
Oh, Father!
nice, Captain. Remind me to put you up for a promotion.
Shirt tail. As I sit and write this, I know that any moment a messenger will arrive to inform this reporter that he is persona non grata. In a way, I am unhappy to leave this country. There is still a large and human story to be told about these tough and valiant people who are fighting despite the obstacles for an end to the years of war. But we have accomplished something. The tiger cages of Roxanne stand condemned before the world as inhumane. We have brought the whole sordid story to the American people. The tales of atrocities of Roxanne are difficult for a civilized society to accept. One prisoner, a 26-year-old social worker, was kept in the pit cages for 60 days. His crime, a mutilated ID card. A woman crammed with 25 others into the pits showed her burn scars to the press. Scars, she said, came when they asked for water and the guards threw lime into the pits. The American embassy here commented today that they are aware of the shortcomings of this country's penal system. Perhaps something has been learned. It remains to be seen. That's 30. Sam Albertson, July 7th, 1970.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes. Exercise your imagination. And join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
The Tiger Cages is an original radio drama written by Keith Walker. Shelley Berman was heard as Sam Albertson. Featured in the cast were Pat Lee, Alan Bergman, Paul Sorensen, Barney Phillips, and Peggy Weber. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Colas, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman, Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.